And kneaded in and formed them into these, or we can make a like a pocket. We can, you know, put the clay on the inside and then leave a reservoir, put the ashes in and seal it that way. And then when you do it that way, then you can make like a deeper bottom, which is like this one, which would came from something like this. And then they have this deeper bottom, and this deeper bottom is from how they form it. It's not actually, you know, the top is only for like that. So we'll do that.
What is the traditional way? Mix with clay, or is it to create a pocket?
The traditional way is to mix it with the clay. Okay, they mixed it all with the clay.
Okay.
You know, as Western people, that's kind of like, ew, because you have chunks sticking out of it. Because everything doesn't come to powder.
Right.
Our ashes are not powder. They're not,
So is that why we started making the holes to make it more palatable for the Western?
I don't know, but that was how, you know, Roger, where's the one that you brought of Fred? We had one of our Fajr brothers died at Pema Osaling, Fred Brown, many of you knew him, and Lama Tarchin had us made stupas. They were made with the receptacle on the inside. Fred's ashes were put inside and sealed. And this is what we were doing with Lama Tarchin, which is again an entirely different way. And my kind of view with it is that Rinpoche liked that our tradition was to keep them, and so he allowed us to keep them. You know, but again, Fred's not an ordinary person. Practitioner.